to all of my many friends and also to my many enemies. And I would like to start off this morning by telling all of my viewers, all of my subscribers, happy, happy Thanksgiving, and may you have many, many more. Not going to be before you too long this morning because I know that, you know, you all are, you know, finishing up cooking and getting the turkey and ham and the, you know, dressing and cranberry sauce, whatever it is on the table. But before you eat today, I would like to speak to you from a subject that I would like to call living a life of Thanksgiving. There's even, you know, there's a gospel song that says every day is a day of Thanksgiving. And that's exactly what that is, because whenever you are living a life of Thanksgiving, Thanksgiving is not only one day a year, you know, during the third Thursday in November. No, Thanksgiving is every single day. Why? Because the Lord blesses us to wake up every single day and blesses us with all kinds of wonderful things, whether it's, you know, life and, you know, things that are in our lives that are good, such as our friends, such as our families, and, you know, things financially, blessings spiritually, blessings emotionally. And so we got to keep that in mind and keep all, not only just during the third Thursday in November or on Thanksgiving Day, but every single day, that spirit of Thanksgiving. Thank God for your friends. Thank God for your families. Thank God for that job. Thank God for that car. Thank God for that home. Thank God for your children. And even, you also have to thank God for your enemies and even some of your haters, because if you look at your enemies and your haters, they're possibly in your life for a reason. Maybe so, you know, one day they can be a blessing to you, or you can even be a blessing to them. Or it's even something that God keeps your haters and enemies in your life while your life is just going crazy and cuckoo all around you. When things that just happen to, you know, you see things just going crazy, you know, just to teach you a lesson. And that is just what we have been seeing, you know, in our city of Chicago and all over our state, even in this very nation, you know, with problems with police and policing and number 45 in the White House doing the stuff that he is doing, you know, racism in the country, just problems in the city, problems in the world, shootings every single place, death every single where, because it's possibly trying to teach us a lesson. Now, with every single thing that is going on, I don't know what lesson that God is trying to teach us with, you know, the racism that's going on in this country. But I'm pretty sure sooner or later, you know, we might see the lesson. I don't know what God is trying to teach us by having Donald Trump in the White House. But I don't know. Maybe it's some kind of a spiritual lesson somewhere. So these are the things that even our haters, not only our friends and family, but even our haters are trying to teach us every single day. You know, our haters, you know, such as if you kids are in school, you know, the demanding teacher, or that, you know, if you have families, you know, that wayward uncle or that wayward aunt or that wayward child. And you know, even some of your, you know, friends or whatever, you know, who fallen like off of, you know, just y'all just fell out. You know what I'm saying? It's a lesson there somewhere. And I think that we need to seek the truth as to what kind of lesson is trying to be taught by what it is that, you know, is going on in our life at that time. I am most of all thankful for life. Thankful for being here almost 45 years, because it will be my 45th birthday in a few more weeks in December. And I'm thankful for my parents, Roosevelt Sr., who is 85 years old, and even my mother, who is 77, who are retired, living in Minnesota. And I thank God that I was able to go and see them earlier this year, about a month ago, to help them out in some of their chores, you know, painting their fence and the back deck and sweeping the garage and you know, all the things I did and everything around the house. And I haven't seen my parents for, you know, 2 years ever since, like, my father, for many of y'all who don't know me personally, who had surgery a couple of years back, I haven't seen my parents since 2016, so I was happy to see them again. And I was even happy to see some of my other family members a couple of weeks before I got to see my parents, because for many of y'all who don't know that I lost my uncle about a couple of weeks before I went to go see my parents. My uncle, the Reverend Elder Charles Estes, I lost him this year. Matter of fact, I was there in the nursing home when he passed away. It's something, you know, to think about that. I mean, but I'm still thankful for those last moments and everything with him. And I'm still thankful that I was able to help the nurse and his daughter even wash and clean his body and, you know, cover him up and everything and wait for the funeral home and all of that. And I'm still thankful and happy that I got a chance to meet some of my other family members and cousins that I have never met, because my uncle had a lot of kids, even a whole lot of other kids that I never met before and didn't even know about. And, you know, so I got a chance to meet some of my other cousins and even exchange numbers with a couple of my other cousins that I never knew before. I got to try to give some of them a call sometime today, too. And I might go over and I might go see my Aunt Lucinda or whatever. You know, that's my Uncle Charlie's ex-wife, who I still talk to and everything's still tight with and all of that. And thankful for my younger brother, even. Thankful, yet my younger brother is doing so well and able to, you know, work a job every single day. Even thankful that I was even able to go and help him go to his place and help him hang a door in his garage. When I was, during the time I was passing through Minnesota visiting my parents. And, you know, thankful he has a car, his own home, and doing so well at the age of 41. Because you find many 41-year-olds who aren't doing so well. Thankful for this gift that I have, even though I'm visually impaired. Thankful that I'm able to take pictures and still have, you know, some sight to do some of the things that I really want to do. Thankful for a whole lot of the people who I have met over the years, not only Black people, but other people of many other different races and even religions, very good and very nice people on this journey that we call life. I was blessed to meet so many different people and blessed to do some, you know, many different things and see many different things and go many different places. And I am so thankful. I'm not trying to say that I don't have my ups and downs every single day, but you know, sometimes, you know, when you really think about it, when you really look back over your life, you come to find out that some of your should we say triumphs, if you will, are bigger and better there's some of your challenges, because challenges, and we know trials and tribulations, that's going to come. But, you know, some of our triumphs and victories and appointments are far much more bigger and better than our disappointments. So I thank God for all of that, that how he has blessed me, well, not only this year, but just over the years, period. And, I know this is a time to get together with family. And I know that we got to also think about and reach out to others who could be upset or could be depressed during this holiday season that we're about to go into, because you find a lot of people who really don't have families or no place to go or nothing to eat for Thanksgiving. So anytime that you're praying over your Thanksgiving meal on this evening or this afternoon or whenever you happen to be serving it, also send up a special prayer for our homeless and people who are less fortunate than the rest of us, because I feel that if it wasn't for the grace of God, then, you know, there go we also. You know, and each one of us could be a paycheck away from being out in the street. And I you know, thank God that that has not, you know, happened to me or even to some people I know, that everybody has a nice warm place to be. But you know, you find some people who are not. And I know that the time that we're about to go into, that, and I can just put it out there, because one thing about it is, at 44 years old, going on 45, I have learned after so long to embrace the truth about myself, even if it's a truth about myself that's not so good or not so flattering or anything like that. But some people who don't know me personally don't know that sometimes I suffer with depression in the wintertime. Now, I feel okay now, but sometimes after New Year's is over, as far as I'm concerned, the snow and the cold after that, you can keep it. I'm ready for it to be summertime again. Because the cold and the snow, you know, we affiliate that with Thanksgiving and especially Christmas and all of that. But, you know, I thank God over the years for having, you know, kept my mind when I thought I would just about go crazy. So, you know, they always say that he's a keeper and he's a mind regulator. And I believe that because, like I said, I might have my days and everything, but I think overall, my days have been good. So I thank God. And for all of you all who might have like problems or even disagreements with your family around this particular time, try to get together, try to talk, try to do something to try to fix it. Because no matter how bad it is, no matter how dirty, no matter how ugly it even looks, I mean, if you really look at it logically, I mean, I'm pretty sure it can't be that bad. At least I'm hoping that it's not that bad and not so far gone that it can never be talked about, never be discussed, and never be fixed. So whatever kind, if there is a problem, try to fix it, and try to fix it now, because you never know. Tomorrow's not promised to any one of us. It's almost like, you know, when you live in this life, as people used to say, here today, gone tomorrow. But sometimes it's a case of here today, gone today. So whatever it is that is going on in your life or between you and a family member or between you and a friend or anything like that, or anyone who you have some kind of opposition or ought against, try to fix it now and fix it as soon as possible, to and that hopefully that will make everything all better. So that's where I'm going to leave it. And I would just like to say that that's why we need to live every single day living in the spirit of Thanksgiving. So that's where I'm going to leave it. I'd like to wish all of my viewers a very wonderful and a very happy Thanksgiving. Don't eat too much, and don't run over anybody when some of you all are going Black Friday shopping for that big screen TV that's on sale. And hopefully, I'll get a chance to talk to you all very, very soon. Until next time, I'll see everybody in the next video. Happy Thanksgiving. Peace and blessings to all.